Why does my heart skip a beat when I sneeze? Am I gonna die? Can extreme surprise actually kill you? Bone marrow transplant, what's that? And is there actually a cure for cancer, huh? Today, we've got three rock star specialists and some of my friends, a cancer doctor, a heart specialist, and myself, an expert in the field of emergency medicine. We're here ready to answer your most bizarre and burning medical questions. Let's dive right into these shocking answers, shall we? Hey everybody, welcome. Here with me today is a good friend of mine, Dr. Robert Kumar. Here with my very good friend, he is an oncologist, hematologist, and most people call him Dr. Vlad. Hey man, thanks for coming on the channel.
My pleasure.
He's here to talk about his specialty. What is that? Tell us about yourself.
Thanks for having me here. I'm a cardiologist and specifically an interventional cardiologist. And what that means is that in addition to practicing general cardiology and treating patients for the variety of heart diseases that you would encounter at different stages of life, I'm also specialized in replacing heart valves and repairing arteries in the heart with catheter-based techniques, so a very minimally invasive approach.
Well, my name is Dr. Vlad Nadion. I'm a cancer, also blood disease doctor, as well as internal medicine certified physician, here to help out my friends.
All right, so we had a bunch of people write in questions for you specifically about cardiology. All so right. We're gonna go through these.
Sure.
And see what's up. Just so you know, some of these are gonna be serious questions. Some might actually be kind of goofy, joking. Don't know what you're gonna get, so hopefully you're ready for it.
Definitely.
Sure.
First question, can you explain to me, like a five-year-old, what cancer is?
In cancer, one of your body parts on an elementary level, very small group of cells, become renegades and they want to survive at expense to the rest of the body. So they expend your energy, sugars, everything just with a single goal of surviving, and in the process of this, they spread and kill you.
Got it. So then cancer is when our body misses the ability to take down that renegade.
Yes, well, general misconception that cancer is just one cell that propagates infinitely and it's exactly the same cell. It is actually a pack of hungry wolves.
Okay.
And they, as they multiply, they change. So every next cell has somewhat different DNA compared to previous one.
Mm-hmm.
They compete with each other and strongest survives. In the end, you're left out with the really, really bad ones. So it's evolution inside of your body.
That's crazy, scary, and really interesting. Somebody asked basically, are there different types of cardiologists and is one better than the other?
So there's many different kinds of cardiologists and all are necessary. No one is better than the other. There's just so many different specialized areas to focus on. General cardiologists, mm-hmm. they have a very comprehensive focus on being able to manage almost all aspects of cardiology. There are specialized doctors called electrophysiologists. They manage all the electrical disorders of the heart.
Mm-hmm.
There's also heart failure cardiologists. And then there is my field, which is interventional cardiology. As we mentioned, treating a variety of structural abnormalities of the heart or implanting devices in the heart or fixing blocked arteries within or near the heart. It is one of the fields with the biggest amount of variety in day-to-day practice.
What are some early warning signs of cancer that people often ignore?
There are many cancers, hundreds of cancers. In fact, paraphrasing Eminem, you know, his palms are sweaty, knees are weak, arms are heavy. Well, you ask WebMD, it's gonna be cancer. Point is, there are no specific things you can point out unless it's on your surface, on your skin. So obviously if you have irregular looking mole, seek medical help.
So in the ER, we see people who would come in with random symptoms and some of them will be like, I lost a bunch of weight. I wasn't trying to lose weight. And they come in with other issues and then I'll do my normal workup and just randomly find it.
It's actually why you guys are so important. So if emergency medicine would not exist, we would always end up with a stage 4 cancer.
Got it. Because we find them late. Is running from your problems a good cardio workout?
Jordan, I think it depends on what problems you're having right now, but running is a great cardio workout.
Sure.
And it means that any type of aerobic exercise of at least moderate intensity, and you know, that's somewhat variable depending on who you are, but at least 25 minutes a day, 5 days a week of some sustained aerobic exercise, you know, reduces your risk of heart disease.
Got it.
And probably improves your longevity as well. And that could be running, cycling, swimming, whatever, you know, you can do at least 2.5 hours a week, because not everybody can have such a regimented schedule. Mm-hmm. And sometimes you can exercise an hour, you know, a couple days, and then, you know, that's probably just as good.
Okay. Well, I know that running from certain problems is good for you. I took a workout class once where I had actually like run from the tiger. So it's running from my problem, I guess.
I guess we just call you the Tiger King.
I called for help twice.
All right, so Russia says they have a cure for cancer. What do you know about that, and do you think it works?
They never said actually that they have cure, but they do have what they call a vaccine. It is directed towards only a few cancers. So it's melanoma, sarcoma, glioblastoma. Idea that they use, they aim to create individualized mRNA-based what they call vaccine, only because it comes from a biologic substance. In theory, it sounds very exciting.
Right, in theory, it sounds really like cool. So there are countries, US, China, almost every country, they are trying to find cures for all different types of cancers.
And that's where this cure seeking becomes politicized, because sometimes those statements made for political gain.
You do a lot of procedures, and so my question to you would be, what they might want to know is, are you at the hospital all the time? Are you on call all the time? Like, what's your life like?
My life is pretty great, but it is busy. I spend about 30% of my time in the office seeing patients. The rest of my work time is spent in the hospital or doing procedures, and even sometimes in the cafeteria. I see you there.
It's really interesting just hearing you speak. You say these really intense words, melanoma, sarcomas. They're simply just the cell that it's dominant, and that's why we name it that, because of cancer, correct? The
By
cancer name.
Cell of origin, yes. Yeah. So basically melanoma, it's skin malignancy coming from melanocytes that pigment your skin. Sarcoma is the connective tissue in simple terms, and glioblastoma, it's a bad tumor in the patient's brains.
What are the early warning signs of a heart attack that people often ignore?
That's a good question. So it can be just a sense of tiredness,
okay,
especially when you're exerting yourself, if you notice it, but I'm really getting out of breath walking up this hill.
Mm-hmm.
Or, you know, I feel like I'm getting heartburn, but I haven't really had any spicy food.
Right.
When you're a younger patient, meaning you're under 65 years old, and even sometimes much younger, it may not be on your radar that this can happen to you.
Got it.
So it's not the first thing you jump to.
Mm-hmm. So I get to see like the acute problem where somebody decides, okay, the symptom is abnormal. So we get like the belching, we get the classic heavy pressure on my chest, radiation to my jaw, shoulder. What ends up happening is I'm able to recognize it. That's my job. And then I have to call Dr. Kumar over here to be like, hey, can you please come down? I need you to actually fix the problem so you can intervene. And next question, this is really good for you because you are also a hematologist. So if vampires drink blood, do they ever have to worry about cancers?
It was only the first person who asked me about drinking blood, given my name, today. But generally, if you think about it, vampires drink a lot of blood rich in iron. So they will get iron accumulation, iron overload, and actually iron overload is one of the risk factors for cancer.
Mm-hmm.
It accumulates in the liver, so it's liver cancers, intestinal cancers, but many other cancers can originate too. So yeah, risky behavior.
Don't drink the blood.
Nobody makes me bleed my own blood. Nobody!
Why do people feel pain in the chest and not the heart during a heart attack?
That has to do with how the heart is innervated, so how the nerves are supplying the heart. When you have one nerve that runs through your entire organ system, mm-hmm, supplying everything, and when it fires off and is sending you an alarm signal, something doesn't feel good, it's really hard for you to pinpoint where that is in your body. And what that leads to is actually a variety of different symptoms. Yes, you get pain in the chest sometimes, but you can get pain in the back. You can get nausea, you can get dizziness, and we know that some patients, especially patients with diabetes and women, tend to have atypical or less symptoms.
Yeah. So in general, if you're just having a new acute symptom that is not normal for you, you should trigger something in your brain to be like, what's happening? Could this be something?
That's absolutely right.
Does sunscreen cause cancer? Be real with me.
People who wear sunscreen, some of them obviously will inevitably develop cancer, but that's a dangerous misconception. Sunscreen is not lethal to development of cancer. In fact, it's very important to prevent cancer. In fact, it is one of the most life-altering cancers, skin cancers. I can't overstate how important it is not, you know, that hoax is dangerous. So I would say wear sunscreen every day. So I do myself.
Sunscreen every day, sun clothing protection, that way you're not lathering up all the time. So that's a little bit just easier.
More convenient.
So that's really good for everybody to know watching that the cancer doctor wears sunscreen every day and sun garments to protect himself.
Nobody's perfect, but I'm trying.
Yes, so broad spectrum. Just make sure you're having broad spectrum. Can you actually die of embarrassment or an extreme surprise?
It feels like you should be able to, but I don't think that's the case most of the time.
Right, like stress. People come into the ER and they're like, I'm so stressed out, I'm gonna cause myself a heart attack.
When you're stressed, your body is in a, what we call a higher catecholaminergic state. So what that means is that you're secreting a lot of stress hormones like cortisol and adrenaline, mm-hmm. and the long-term metabolic effects on higher levels of these in your blood can actually mean that you're getting more aggressive plaque buildup in your arteries,
okay.
leading to heart attacks and strokes. So, you know, you have a terrible experience and you're just gonna die of a heart attack,
right.
it's very unlikely, right. but it is important to manage your stress for your long-term heart disease risk.
Got it. Is there a best type of cancer to get if you had to choose?
Well, cancer sucks. The one that is easy to spot, like a skin cancer, uh-huh. is probably the one that if you would absolutely hard press me.
Yep.
Just a non-melanoma.
Non-melanoma, like a basal cell.
Yeah, and okay. so just because relatively easy to spot, mm-hmm. a lot of older people get it, we zap it or freeze it and move on. But important to say, if you do have it once, it means that you've been exposed to ultraviolet at a very high grade and you're likely to have another one. So that is why it's so important to use sun protection.
Why does my heart skip a beat when I sneeze? Am I gonna die potentially every time I sneeze?
You might, no.
Oh.
Skipped heartbeats are actually a very normal thing mm-hmm. for people to have. They do not, in and of themselves, indicate that there is something wrong with your heart.
When you sneeze, does it actually skip a beat?
It could, but typically no.
Oh, interesting.
Most of the time when you sneeze, your heart carries through that whole unsettling experience without a hitch.
Interesting. If I microwave my food in plastic containers, am I basically marinating it in cancer?
Great question. I mean, if your plastic container is full of cancer cells, then you will marinate it in cancer, but there are different plastic. And so what's important to know is that some are PVCs. They can expose you to phthalates and specific cancer carcinogens that are known to increase cancer risk, but some like polyethylene, there's no data about this. I don't microwave plastic in and try to stay away from TV dinners given the poor nutritional value.
Yes, and I use glass for my microwave.
Well, definitely safer.
Yeah. How does a bone marrow transplant actually work?
So bone marrow is a simple process of taking sample of a tissue that is located in all bones in our body, like in our spine and pelvis. Usually the most modern way of doing this is to put patients somewhat out, so they get some medications for sleep and pain medications, and then we use a special drill that just takes 15 seconds. That's it. So no need to be afraid of it. It's not as bad as it sounds.
That is the bone marrow transplant. Well, why would you actually do that for an individual?
Essentially, it's our last line approach, and we suspect that if we just take natural course, the cancer will take over and kill the patient. So obviously, alternative, which is surviving with a bone marrow transplant, is better. So it's our essentially last ditch approach.
And there you have it, today's deep dive into some of the most thought-provoking cancer and heart medical questions out there. Huge thanks to my friends, Dr. Vlad and Dr. Kumar, for sharing their expertise in oncology and cardiology. I really hope their insight was helpful for you, and please let me know. Do you have any other medical questions on cancer or the heart specifically? Or perhaps you want to see a different medical specialty like dermatology or anesthesiology? Please let me know that too. This is your chance to ask a doctor, so drop all your questions and thoughts in the comments below, and who knows, we might just use them in the next video. If you found this video helpful, binge watch this playlist right here for more health tips and expert answers. And please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with someone who's curious about their health. Thanks for watching and stay healthy, my friends.